Ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to all of you. My name is Katrin Prüfig, and I'll be your moderator, and if you like, your navigator through today's conference, Human Biomonitoring for Science and Chemical Policy, a conference taking place in remarkable times due to the pandemic. So I'm even more delighted to see you all here live in Berlin, and an even greater audience of more than 500 of you online. Welcome. In just a few seconds, I will hand over to the official welcoming words from one of our hosts, but let me mention in the beginning that we have worked out a really interactive conference here today. It's easy for our live audience here in Berlin to take part and contribute to the discussion, but I'd also like to invite our online audience to actively take part. And you can do so by using the Q&A function in the live stream, which is on the top right-hand side. And we will include your questions and comments as best we can in the ongoing discussion. In our first keynote today, we will hear about the constant balancing act human biomonitoring means for all the stakeholders. We will hear about the progress achieved so far and the challenges that lie ahead. Please give a very warm welcome to Germany's Federal Minister for the Environment, Nature Conservation and Nuclear Safety, Svenja Schulze.
Hans Brink, Dirk Messner, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the third International Human Biomonitoring Conference here in Berlin and online. It is so good to see you all in person here, some of you. Having meetings in the internet is fantastic. But meeting someone in person, I think that is really a difference. And I was never aware of that before in such an intensive manner than yet. So warm welcome to all of you. The focus of this conference is human biomonitoring as a really important tool to the support chemical policy making. We are holding this conference as a part of the German's EU presidency. We are holding it in the context of the European Green Deal and more precisely in the context of the chemical strategy that the European Commission is about to publish. EU Commissioner Virginijus Sinkevičius will join this conference later today and provide us with the latest information. And the strategy will then be discussed by some of the key EU players. The European Green Deal has the ambition and the potential to make the EU industry fit for the challenges of the future. The goal is to make EU industry a successful competitor in the world market, but also a leader on the path to a more sustainable future. The chemical industry is an important part of that transformation, and we need its innovative power to create safer and environmentally smarter products to combat climate change and enhance the circular economy. Safe, green chemistry is key for sustainable production and consumption and also for implementing the European Green Deal. Creating a sustainable chemical industry is a challenge. It's a challenge not only for the EU, but for the entire globe. UNEP estimates that global production of chemicals will double by 2030, and this cannot mean that harm to health and the environment will double as well. In this context, Germany will be hosting the fifth session of the International Conference on Chemicals Management in July next year. It was planned for this year, but because of the virus, we have to postpone the conference. And this conference will decide on an ambitious and really ambitious global framework on chemicals and waste. Safe chemistry relates to both to the environment and to human health. Today's conference focused on the latter, how we can protect the population from harmful chemicals. In order to address this challenge, we need a really sound scientific basis. The first step is to know how what chemicals and how much of them get into our bodies. This is exactly what human biomonitoring is about. In Germany, we are at the forefront of human biomonitoring. We generate population representative data in our German environmental surveys. We investigate traditional chemical substances such as lead and mercury, as well as more modern ones such as glyphosate or phthalates, bisphenol A, and parabens. Really hard to speak all these chemicals, so you know what I mean. Let me give you a few examples of the kind of projects the German Environment Ministry is conducting with the support of the Environmental Agency, with the support, Dirk Messner is here, of this really important agency. With the help of our Environmental Specimen Bank, we create timelines that allow us to observe development over really many, many years. We have data that dates back to the 80s, and that is really truly unique. Since 2010, we have been enlarging the toolbox of human biomonitoring by developing methods of measuring chemicals that couldn't be measured before. This is being undertaken as a part of a remarkable cooperation with the German Chemicals Industry Association, and it is supported by a panel of experts from science, from industry, and from relevant authorities. All of the new methods developed are made available worldwide. There is another reason for Germany's leading role in human biomonitoring. Since 2016, we have been coordinating HBM4EU, the research program that is co-founded by the European Commission, with the aim of establishing an EU-wide human biomonitoring system, HBM4EU, that is an important part of the framework in which this conference is taking place. And the next big EU project, which includes human biomonitoring, that is already on the horizon. A new chemicals risk assessment partnership will be part of the new EU research program, Horizon Europe, which is about to start in 2021. Ladies and gentlemen, chemicals are everywhere. We make use of them every single day. They are a major factor in our quality of life. During the coronavirus pandemic, they have protected our health in form of disinfectants, pharmaceuticals, and as a part of protective gear for doctors and nurses. Chemicals are not inherently bad or dangerous. But some of them do have harmful effects on human health and on our environment. There is therefore an urgent need to improve the protection of our population from exposure to many chemicals and from exposure to hazardous chemicals. And this is true for our food, for the air we breathe, with the products we use, and the water we drink. There is much at stake, and I hope that this conference will take us another step forward towards a more sustainable use of chemicals. I trust that you will enjoy the interesting presentation and discussions today, and I thank you very much for your attention. Thanks a lot.